to turn it off. The reason why I'm doing this is like a mission for me, since I am a physician by profession, and I'm a very avid fan of Jesus, and I know our situation right now with the pandemic and also with the winter storm and all the other domino effect of this pandemic. A lot of people are so desperate and so so overwhelmed by this problem. But as you can see, Jesus gave his life for us so that we'll be able to go to heaven. But of course, we have to do our part. We have to try to abide with his will, because we know that he knows us more than he knows we know ourselves. And I did a earlier video, but didn't turn out well, so I'm just re-recording because I have a very important message tonight, and I would like to share with you this music that is very appropriate for the Lenten season. It's inspiring. It wakes up make our faith stronger, realizing what he has done for us. And you know, consequence there should be a barter or something, you know, because he gave his life for us, and then we have to do our part. He has just given us all the tools to be able to cope with situations, with all our problems. Because he's all-knowing, he knows our problem even before we get it. But it will be up to our choice, because he gave us free choice. He gave us the intellect. You know, we only have to do our part. So let me show you this the song. Let's just hear it, because I get carried away with the song, you know, because it's so meaningful, and try to understand how much he has done for us. And so in return, we should ask, what can we do for him? So he will be happy, and he would say it's his sacrifice was really worth it, because he died for us. So we have to do our part to love him with all our heart, with all our soul, with all our mind. So let me try this. We are the reason by the Avalon.
As little children, we would dream Christmas morn of all the gifts and toys we knew we'd find, but we never realized the baby born was blessed and gave us the greatest gift.
Beautiful song. Very beautiful. Thank you for whoever created that song. We are the reason he died on the cross. We are the reason that he suffered and died. He has given everything to us so that we live happy. We live a joyful and holy life so that in the end, we will be with him forever. And he even gave us the Bible, is a recipe on how we should live. A prescription on how we should live. And he have given us elders in our church to help us. So there's no reason to give up, not to move forward. And I was just reading Isaiah 53, verse 4 to 5. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. And there is one more verse that I was looking at earlier. In Exodus 15:26, it says, if you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, give ear to his commandments and keep all his statutes, I will put none of the diseases on you which I have brought on the Egyptians. For I am the Lord who heals you. So how, my God, he's so powerful, he's so great. He's the divine physician. In Malachi 4, verse 2, it says, but to you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings, and you shall go out and grow fat like stall-fed cubs. Lord my God, it says on Psalm 30, verse 2 to 3 says, Lord my God, I cried out to you and you healed me. O Lord, you brought my soul up from the grave. You have kept me alive that I should not go down to the pit. So yes, being alive is so good. Because you still have a mission. And so much people who are afflicted by diseases would like, especially those terminal diseases, how much would they would like to have a lease in another lease in life. So if you are down and miserable and hurt, try to think of Jesus' suffering. how much stripes he was hit, how much painful those nails that are put on the wrist, that he was sweating, you know, when he was just thinking about it in the while he was praying in the garden of in the garden before he got crucified, his sweat was blood, because he knew the pain that is going to go through for us. And what should we give in return? What should we give in return? We have to abide by him. We have to make him happy with our lives. So don't mind the other people, you know. Just love them, you know, but don't get distracted from other people's problem or slander on you. It is nothing compared to the slander that Jesus has gotten that time. So I pray that everybody will. Every opportune time, talk to him. And if you think you have some, are having some problems, talk to him and cast out the devil. Cast out the demonic forces that is in your problem, so that the grace, the enlightenment from the Holy Spirit will come freely to you. And a lot of times we have to swallow our pride. So, because in the end, when we die, it's only between God and us. There's no assistant there. There's no other people but us, but you, facing our judgment, our Lord. Did we love him more than, did we love him above all things? When you say you love God, you believe in God, then do not worry. Do not panic. Just do what you can do, and you know, set your priorities. If there's multiple problems, try to set the priorities. So I hope I have imparted that Jesus is the reason for us to live. We have to make him happy. Okay? Is it a deal? Good night. God bless us all. I'm praying for you.